I'll do this. I'll take this on. But to get back to a little bit more about the history of Japan and the Nishikigoi, the koi, is that there's stories behind them. You know, if you look back into Asian art, if any of you are interested in Asian art, you'll see pictures of koi in artwork. You'll see, the gifts. I mean, back in the 1400s, another royalty was trying to impress another Japanese woman, and so he built a pond and filled it with koi. At one, there was only 5 types of koi originally in Japan. Kawaki was the first one, because there's many different varieties. But the 5th variety, the Kiyotsuri, which is a yellow and black koi, was at one point in Japanese history was worth more than gold. So if you owned a Kiyotsuri, it was worth more than the weight of gold. So there's a history that is not all connected, again, with money or the value of a koi. It's connected with the story that goes behind it. The carp that, because carp can jump and carp are known for endurance, the carp that struggled so hard to get up the waterfall that he was honored by being turned into a dragon. And that's why May 5th in Japan is Koinobori Day. It's a celebration of originally Boys' Day, it's now Children's Day. And they fly koi flags everywhere in honor of the one carp that made it to the top to show the heritage to their children. I mean, I really wish, I celebrate Koinobori Day, but I mean, we should have a Children's Day. Why don't we have a Children's Day? Why, you know what I mean? And so these values, and it's not because I respect the Japanese culture so much, it's because there's a lot of truth in it. There's a lot of truth and there's a lot of a story behind it which helps, future generations. So I'm very honored to be